And I like to put some salt on it because it makes it taste better red. And when we put the salt of God's Word on something that doesn't seem to be too sweet, it sweetens it and makes it palatable to our mouths. God bless you. We're so thankful you're here this morning. There's a lot of people out this morning. I guess a little cool weather, they picked their coats up and couldn't get them out for this time. But I am so thankful this morning that the Lord is here and that He's on His throne and that He's in charge of every situation. I come to serve notice to the devil. You're not in charge of nothing. Satan, you're not in charge of nothing. You don't even have the keys to your own.
Thank you.
fowls are out there in the world.
Yeah.
Worship with them as they sing this morning.
My Lord.
Somehow forgotten.
God.
Thank you.
Praise the Lord.
Good again.
Yes, he is. Yes, he is.
Oh.
here. So thankful that you came to be in the Lord's house today. I know there's those in vision, and I know there's those that I've invited and what a tension this morning said, I was up all night in pain. I said, that's just the devil trying to keep you out of the house of God. Well, it's real. I said, sure it's real. I said, the devil can inflict on your body pain.
Come on.
I said, but God is able. I said, if you'll just get up and come on to church. Well, I didn't sleep all night. I said, come to church and go home and sleep. I said, you'll go home healed.
Come on.
I believe that.
You'll sleep tonight.
I believe that.
Amen.
I just looked at them to this.
Come on, Pastor, preach.
Philippians 4:19. Let's read.
But my God shall supply all your needs according to his riches in the Lord by Christ Jesus.
I want us to read it once or more time, but when we get to the word all your needs, I want you to stop
all your needs.
And I want you to think about what you need from God. I know you need a job. I know you need it. But we want it to be in the will of God.
Come on now.
We want it to be in the will of God. That's all the way to order.
The divine will.
But we're going to read this one more time. Whatever your need is, we're going to stop with the word need.
God's
and I want you to tell God, we're just going to stop and take a break. A praise break. And I want you to tell God, Lord, you know what I need.
The
Bible says it's impossible for God to lie. And his word said he can supply all your needs. And put an S on it, needs. But your needs, something that you need from God today. You've been praying for it, you've been seeking God for it. But now this morning, God has brought us together.
For it to happen.
In unity. Collectively.
It's going to happen.
Let's read. But my God shall supply all your need. Now tell me what you need.
Yeah.
people But in Chronicles 7:14, if my people who are called by my name will humble themselves and pray and seek my face and what? He was a God that kept him, blessed him. He learned that he had to fear no evil because what? Thy rod and thy staff, they comfort me. Fear can't touch us if you're full of the Holy Ghost. Fear is the opposite of faith. What is faith? Faith is the substance of things that are things that you have hope for and the things that are not seen.
Yet seen.
When the children of Israel came up out of Egypt, they found that God was their supplier.
Amen.
God protected them from the Egyptian army at the Red Sea. He caused a cloud to come between them
as a barrier.
And it was dark.
As a barrier.
It was dark. No one came near the other. Exodus 14 and 20. I know I skipped some scripture, but go to Exodus 14 and 20.
Oh, my Jesus. And it came between the camp of the Egyptians and the camp of Israel. And it was a cloud and darkness to them.
You know what that cloud was? That was the power of God hovering over them. That was the power of God. He shielded them from what was coming. God shields us from what was coming.
Yes, Pastor. Amen.
spoke to that rock and water started coming out. They all got their water pitchers. They go by the rock at 9 a.m. and it fill it up. They go by at noon and it would fill it up. They go by at night and it fill it up. If Papa woke up at midnight and said, I'm thirsty, he could go to that rock and he could get water. Why? Because God's supply is never out. He is always able to supply all of our needs. Praise God. God protected them. He fed them. And I want to preach to you that He's a God that's yet alive and He's faithful.
Even now, yes, sir.
He's faithful.
Even now.
His name is Jesus. They called me yesterday and said, my brother was having a little heart attack. I took off the gun and got over to my atrium. And my niece called back and said, what is his heart? I said, he's just low of blood. Blood's getting out of his body and they don't know where it's going.
Come on, Pat.
Amen. So they pumped some blood into him. And hey, he was feeling good. I said, tell him not to come. He's got church tomorrow. I said, well, I just got through praying all the way that God would protect you from a heart attack.
Yes.
He said, well, the doctor didn't. He said, there's no heart attack. The heart's fine. I still have no blood. I said, well, we're going to pray that God goes to where the blood's leaking
out now.
And then cauterizes it and fixes it. Amen. I believe God.
Yes. I know you.
You come too late to tell me God cannot heal.
Right.
He healed everybody. We have all these people. help us, and each one was healed. We find out all these believers that have been added to the church brought all their sickness and diseases to the Lord.
Preacher, pastor.
He healed them, every one.
Amen.
Hebrews 13:8, Jesus Christ the same yesterday.
Amen.
Today.
Amen.
Brother, look at your neighbor and say, he's my supplier.
Yeah. He is my supplier.
Say, his word can't lie.
His word cannot lie.
No. Matthew 3:11, he said, indeed, I baptize you with water into repentance. That's what happened, Brother Justin. You repented and God baptized you.
Yes,
he
sir.
He said, I baptize you with water into repentance.
Amen.
And he will come up after me as my Lord and I.
Hallelujah.
Who shall you find not worthy to bear? He shall baptize you with the Holy Ghost and fire.
Yeah.
I want you to know these people that run around there, you don't know what it is, the fire needs to burn. Church all the time because I'm trying to get another doctor. I am out of the will of God.
That's right.
I understand your job may require it sometimes, but when you got to work all the time and you don't never get to be in church, it is out of the will of God.
Yes, it is.
God is our supply. I know it takes time. Would you humble yourself and find a place and just say, God, you're my supply.
Oh, my Jesus.
If you need faith, ask.
Amen.
If you need joy,
ask.
That's right. Ask.
If you need peace, just ask. If you need deliverance, just ask. It doesn't matter what it is. Jesus is the supplier.
That's right.
You can't do it, but He can.
That's a fact, Pastor.
Amen.
You know what we do? We interfere with God when we try to fix it.
That's the truth.
Amen.
We do.
We interfere with God's business when we try to fix it.
That's right. Amen.
Because He's our supplier.
Oh my God.
You can't do it. I can't do it, but He can.
Yes, sir.
Amen.
I believe it. I believe it. Yes, sir.
I ask you this morning, and I close it. God's already moved.
Oh God.
I got two or three pages, but it's no sense. God's already moved.
Yes,
and the Lord is wanting to fill you with the baptism of the Holy Ghost.
Yet again.
He's wanting to fix your need.
Amen.
I want us to stand. Our whole call is going to be where you're standing.
The church is the altar.
Right where you stand is going to become your altar.
Your memorial.
And I want us to close our eyes, and I want us to throw our hands and our heads to God.
In the name of Jesus.
And I want you now to let God know what you need. On April the 8th, 11:40-34 in the morning, God's ready to supply your need. He said, I can supply all your needs according to the riches of His glory. I want you to begin to talk to the Lord. Now let God have our
heart.
We're going to take a few minutes and we're going to talk to God. Now if you don't have a need, you're dismissed. But for those that have a need, you're going to have to get serious with God. You're going to have to let Him know. You want your dead healed? Get your hands in the air and tell God. It's not enough that Pastor prayed for it. You brought me a prayer request. Lift your hands. And I want you to ask God to touch Him right now for that cause. Right now, God is going to use your prayer for me to touch Him. How serious are you? How serious are you? Get serious with God. Because He said, I am a supplier of all your needs. God is a supplier of all your needs. The Lord reminded me yesterday, if they will seek my face and turn from their evil ways, I will hear from heaven and I will meet their needs. So now it's between you and Him. I'll come to tell you this morning that He says He's willing and well able to meet your needs. If it's your body, trust the Lord for healing, because it's already done. If it's deliverance from evil spirits that are oppressing you, I bind them in the name of Jesus. I adjure you to leave these people alone. They are covered by the blood. They makes the blind. God's opening doors right now that you thought were shut. He is your supply. God is providing things right now that you thought would never happen. God is providing them. He's mighty at work when you don't feel it. He's mighty at work when you don't see it. He is a miracle worker. He's a way maker. Will you allow him to do it for you? You get the day and time, because when it happened, I want you to remember, it happened. God supplied my need while I was there at church. God opened some doors while I was at church. God removed some obstacles while I was at church. I will supply all your need, N-E-E-B, according to the riches of glory by Christ Jesus. Oh, God, what a sweet presence of the Holy Ghost. God, I believe you're in work. God, I believe you're meeting needs even now. I believe, God, that you're my supplier. You're this church's supplier. God, you make a way when there is no way. Oh, God. He is our supplier. He is our supplier. God, you see those things in my life, God. You see the kickback that I'm getting. You see the rebellion that I'm getting. God, you see the obstacles that seem to be in the way. God, all it takes is one word from you, and it's gone. There only takes one word from you and it's gone. In Jesus. In Jesus. Let's lift our hands and praise Him. And doing so, we're through to be His guest. Don't forget God's strength of Tuesday night prayer at 8:06. Lord, we love you this morning. Thank you for your word. You said, I've said my word and my word healed. Praise God.